should have enough funds to funnel more money toward public education and reform property tax systems.
That is according to Texas Comptroller Glenn Hager, who's released his revenue estimate report today. KXAN's Steffi Lee looks at just how much money Texas is expected to have.
The state of Texas has money.
For 2020-2021, we estimate state revenue available for general purpose spending will be $119.12 billion.
But will this be enough for lawmakers to address the current budget gap and to craft the next two-year budget? The things on their radar that will cost the most: Hurricane Harvey recovery, Medicaid expenses, school finance, and property tax reform. Comptroller Glenn Hager says it's possible, but warns not to go overboard.
I believe that recent economic conditions warrants a more cautious revenue outlook for this coming biennium.
Here's one reason why: declining oil prices in recent months. In late December, oil prices in West Texas dropped to $48 per barrel.
There's a nice sweet spot, because if they're too high, you get to $100 oil. That's not good for you and I as the Texas consumer at the pump. Yet at the same time, if they get down to $30, that's not good for these numbers that we have up here either.
The state's rainy day fund, set aside for emergencies, is estimated to grow to $15 billion from the current $12.5 billion. Governor Greg Abbott issued a statement saying he looks forward to working with the legislature by addressing school finance and limiting property tax growth. Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick says the Senate is confident it can accomplish those goals as well, in addition to increasing teacher pay. Steffi Lee, KXAN News.
The biennial revenue estimate released today predicts a 9.5% increase in sales tax revenues. Oil production tax collections are projected to generate up to $7.4 billion. Natural gas expected to raise $3.3 billion, up more than 9% from the previous biennium. Comptroller Hager said that people also aren't buying as many cars in Texas, resulting in lower motor vehicle tax collections. The next two-year budget will likely not see any money from there transferred to the state highway fund.